The genetic and cultural history of the Basque people is an enigma. On one hand, they have exceedingly high levels of a genetic marker associated with the spread of the Indo-Europeans. On the other, they do not speak an Indo-European language, which is exceedingly rare in Europe. So in this video, we're going to look at the genetic history of the Basque country, the main haplogroups in this area, and we'll also look at their incredible language. Now, the home of this people is the Basque country. Located in the Western Pyrenees, it straddles the border between France and Spain, with the city of Bilbao the largest city in this region. One fascinating aspect of the Basque people is the language they speak. This is because the Basque language is classified as a language isolate, meaning it has no clear genetic relationship to any other modern languages. It is the only language isolate in Europe. Now look at this map. It shows the languages that are part of the larger Indo-European language family. As you can see, the vast majority of European languages are in this category, including Spanish and French. In this small grey zone is the Basque country. This puts the Basque language in a very unique category, which is known as Euskara to the Basques. Even within this category though, the Basque language is even more unique. The other major languages in Europe that aren't Indo-European are largely all in another language family, Uralic languages, which is linked to a Siberian ancestral component. These are Finnish, Hungarian, Estonian, and some languages of Russia around the Ural Mountains. Yet the Basque language isn't a Uralic language, and it's not a Turkic language either. Why is the Basque language not Indo-European then, and why is it so unique? Well, it is believed that the Basque language actually predates the arrival of the Indo-European languages. It is believed to be a survivor of pre-Indo-European tongues, serving as a window into the deep history of Europe. Given that early Indo-European languages are thought to have reached Europe around 3000 to 2500 BC, the ancestral line of the Basque language is extremely old. Its origins remain a mystery, however. Some genetic research we will cover later in this video will give us some insights though. Theories range from links to ancient Iberian languages to distant connections with Caucasian languages, though none have been definitively proven. We do know it is related in some way to the extinct Aquitanian language. This was spoken by the Aquitani, a people living in Roman times in part of what we now call southwestern France. Another people that spoke a related language was the Vascones. They were a pre-Roman tribe who lived in the Western Pyrenees, and they are often considered ancestors to modern Basques. The Basque language though, despite centuries of external influence, from Latin to Spanish and French, has preserved its unique grammatical structure and vocabulary, making it all the more intriguing. But what does the genetic history of the Basque people say about all this? And like I say, there is a bit of a paradox when it comes to their genetics and their culture. Now in general, the foundational genetics of Europeans is made up of three main sources, as well as a little Neanderthal ancestry that goes way back. The three main sources are though, hunter-gatherer ancestry, then early European farmer ancestry, and then steppe ancestry during the Bronze Age. Now an older theory was that the ancestral line of the Basque people had remained completely isolated from essentially all incoming waves of migrations for tens of thousands of years. In other words, some argued that the Basques shared most of their ancestry with these ancient hunter-gatherer populations. More recent studies, and in particular advances in genetic research, has provided a much more accurate picture though. Although Basque people have some hunter-gatherer ancestry like most other Europeans, they have much higher levels of early European farmer ancestry than initially thought. Now the first farmers arrived in Iberia around 5500 BC, bringing Anatolian-like ancestry into this region. A fascinating study from 2015 found some interesting connections between modern Basques and these early farmers. They sequenced the genetics of 8 individuals dated to between 3500 and 1500 BC. These people were from the El Portalón cave in Spain, which is just west of the Basque country. When this study compared these ancient individuals to modern European populations, they found that Basques and Sardinians have the highest genetic affinity to early farmers in general. After further refining their comparison, they found that the Basque people were genetically closest to the El Portalón farmers. The Sardinians, on the other hand, were closer to all other early European farmer groups. Now this study also speculated on the origins of the Basque language. They write that, a possible interpretation of the role of Basque in this scenario would be that it is a descendant of the language or one of the languages of the early farmers. So the Basque language could trace back to these early farming populations. This study does note that the origins of the Basque language could be pre-agricultural though, before these early farmers arrived, but it is difficult to know for sure. What about haplogroups around this time though? Well, before we look at that, if you're enjoying this video, please consider subscribing. And if you'd like access to member-only videos, please check out my Patreon page. Or if you prefer everything on one platform, please check out the members area on YouTube. Just click the join button to get more information. I will also put links in the description below. Thank you, and now on with the video. Now, this study sequenced the genetics of these 8 individuals. As you can see on the maternal side, U5 was the most common, followed by H3. Branches of K1, Gy1 and X2C are among the other mitochondrial haplogroups in these ancient people. On the Y-DNA side, only 2 males were among the 8. H2 and I2A2A were the male markers. So we know by this point that the Bas are a mixture of hunter-gatherer and a good amount of early European farmer ancestry, but what about the third component, the steppe ancestry? Well, this last component is particularly interesting and represents a genetic and cultural paradox. This spread of steppe ancestry is associated with migrations from the Pontic-Caspian steppe beginning around 3000 BC. It is connected to the early spread of Indo-European lineages and the Yamnaya culture, as well as other connected peoples. One such connected people in relation to Iberia in particular was the Bell-Baker complex, with R1b the most common Y-DNA marker amongst them. Now, we know that the Y-DNA haplogroups changed dramatically across the whole of Iberia because of the steppe ancestry. As I noted in my previous video on Iberian DNA and the evolution of hazel eyes, a study that looked at the genetic history of the Iberian Peninsula over the past 8,000 years found massive changes in Y-DNA. Previously common Y-DNA haplogroups in Iberia, such as I2, G2 and H, were almost completely replaced by R1b M269. And if we look at the Basque country today, over 80% of Basque men carry the Y-DNA haplogroup R1b. These are some of the highest rates of R1b in the world. The subclade R1b DF27 is especially common in the Basque country, as it's found in over 70% of Basque men. As a point of interest, results from a 2017 study indicate that this subclade arose in Iberia itself, around 4,200 years ago. The genetic and cultural history of the Basque people represents a paradox, however. Despite having some of the highest levels of this Indo-European genetic marker, R1b, in the world, they also retained their non-Indo-European lineage. Why is this though? What were the drivers of this? What were the reasons for this? Well, the full genetic history of the Basque country could actually help us understand this linguistic history. We know that after the Bronze Age influx, the Basque population experienced long periods of genetic continuity and isolation. Present-day Basques are essentially descendants of typical Iron Age Iberian populations. They are distinguished mainly by the lack of later admixture events. Unlike most of Iberia, the Basque region did not significantly intermix with subsequent migrations. These were people like the ancient Greeks or Romans, Iron Age Celts, and medieval Moorish rulers. This study on the genomic history of Iberia, for example, concluded that present-day Basques are best described as a typical Iron Age population, without the admixture events that later impacted the rest of Iberia. In practice, this means that from around 1000 BC onward, the Basque region saw comparatively little gene flow from outside. And this gene flow was associated with further linguistic changes across Iberia as a whole. Now, we do think that the Bell-Baker culture may have spoken an early form of Indo-European, possibly ancestral to Celtic, although this is debated. Yet even if they did speak some form of early Indo-European languages, some Proto-Indo-European language, this linguistic influence was far from uniform across the peninsula. Native languages would also have been spoken alongside this early form of Indo-European. During the Iron Age, Celtic groups brought their languages into Iberia, with Celtic languages a branch of the broader Indo-European language family. We know that this linguistic spread was again not uniform though. Non-Indo-European languages like Iberian and Aquitanian were still spoken, and we know that genetically this Celtic migration had little impact on the Basque region. Then, when the Romans came, the Basque country again didn't see a notable genetic change. Whereas most of Iberia saw a shift in their ancestry to the Eastern Mediterranean, the Basque region was an exception. The Roman conquest of Iberia began around 220 BC and expanded over the centuries. This expanded the use of Latin, which evolved into Vulgar Latin and then the Romance languages over time. Spanish, Portuguese and French are all Romance languages, which are a branch of the Indo-European language family. The Basque country, however, was little developed by the Romans. This Latinization, therefore, did not take hold in a major way. Now, there are various reasons for this. A mix of northern geography, historical circumstance, and cultural tenacity allowed the Basque country to retain its indigenous speech while neighbours adopted Latin. A lax Roman presence in the region, alliances that preserved Basque autonomy, a strong sense of identity, and the protective isolation of the Pyrenean environment all allowed them to weather the pressures that extinguished other languages. And this goes to show that the spread of the R1B haplogroup wasn't always associated with linguistic change. Although early forms of Indo-European were probably introduced with their steppe ancestry in the Belbikers, it often didn't uniformly replace native languages in one swoop. It was later migrations, such as Celtic expansions and Roman invasions, that caused further linguistic changes. This probably wasn't just unique to Iberia as well. A gradual linguistic change probably happened in other areas as well. Yet the Basque region was unique, and the fact that these events didn't have a genetic impact on them in any meaningful way. This, of course, indicates that these events had a limited impact on the Basque region overall. It is also clear that this region around the Basque country today has had a strong sense of identity for thousands of years, going back to peoples like the Vascones. This, coupled with geography and other factors, allowed the Basque to be isolated from genetic and linguistic changes that happened all around them. But what do you think? Please let me know in the comments below. Now, what are the main haplogroups in the Basque country today? Well, as noted earlier, R1B is the most common Y-DNA marker amongst Basque men, and it's exceedingly high at over 80% in general, with some estimates as high as 90%. The most common subclade of R1B in this region is R1B-DF27 that probably originated in Iberia, with R1B connected to steppe ancestry of course. The second most common Y-DNA haplogroup is I2A, a very old haplogroup in Europe. On the maternal side, H is the most common mitochondrial haplogroup amongst the Basques at around 40-50%. We know the first farmers were important in this marker's spread. Branches of U are the second most common maternal marker. U5 and U4 are the most common branches of U, which again are very old haplogroups in Europe that go back to hunter-gatherer populations. Other mitochondrial haplogroups found in the Basque region at lower levels include J, T, K, and V. We also find the mitochondrial haplogroup X in the Basque country at lower levels. This marker is pretty rare in Europe and is connected to the arrival of Near Eastern farmers during the Neolithic. This again shows the Basque connection to these early farmers. As far as how the Basque region today compares to other parts of Iberia, we know it is genetically distinct, but not completely isolated. A 2019 study, for example, that looked at the genetic differences across Iberia, found that the Basque region forms a distinct genetic cluster from the rest of Spain. Basque people do share similarities with surrounding populations though, such as other regions of Spain, but obviously the Basque region didn't have these later admixture events, such as North African ancestry in any reasonable way. I should also note that the Basques have an unusually high percentage of the blood type Rh negative. This is around 30-35% compared to around 15% of most of Europe. However, this is a story for another time, and let me know in the comments below if you're interested in a follow-up video on this topic at some point and your thoughts on the Basques in general. And let me know if you have some Basque ancestry as well in the comments below. So the Basque people are a fascinating story of preserving their cultural identity across thousands of years. And we have seen that they were genetically sheltered from later migrations and invasions to a large degree after around 1000 BC. But what is the genetic history of the Iberian Peninsula as a whole, and why are hazel eyes so common in this part of the world? To find out, please click here. Thanks for watching, please let me know your thoughts below, and please subscribe and hit the bell. If you'd like access to member-only videos, please check out my Patreon page or the YouTube members area on YouTube. Just click the join button to find out more information. But yeah, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.